السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. قال الله جل في علاه في قرآن الكريم في سورة آل عمران، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: ولتكن منكم أمة يدعون إلى الخير ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر وأولئك هم المفلحون. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: من رأى منكم منكرا فليغير بيده، فإن لم يستطع فبلسانه، فإن لم يستطع فبقلبه، وذلك أضعف الإيمان. صحيح المسلم. وقال الشيخ عبد العزيز بن باز رحمه الله عليه في مجموع الفتوى ابن باز: وقد دلت أدلة القرآن والسنة على وجوب الدعوة إلى الله عز وجل، وأنها من الفرائض الواجبة. Allah the Exalted said in the glorious Quran in Surah Al Imran chapter 3 verse 104: Let there arise out of you a group of people inviting to all that is good, enjoying al-ma'roof, Islamic monotheism and all that Islam orders one to do, and forbidding al-munkar, polytheism and disbelief and all that Islam forbids, and it is they who are successful. Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala who narrated, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever among you sees an evil action, he should stop it with his hand. If he cannot, then with his tongue. If he cannot, then he should feel bad in his heart. And that is the weakest form of faith, weakest form of iman. Sayyid al-Muslim. Sheikh Abdul Aziz bin Baz rahimahullah alayhi said, the evidence from the Quran and Sunnah indicates that it is obligatory upon us to do da'wah, to call people to Allah, may He be exalted and glorified, and that this is one of the obligatory duties. Majmu' al-Fatawa, Volume 1, page 330. So my dear brothers and sisters, it is obligatory upon us, it is our duty to spread the message of Allah, to spread the deen of Allah, to do da'wah to Muslims as well as non-Muslims. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, بَلِّغُ أَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَا, convey from me even an ayah of the Quran. Sahih al-Bukhari. So we should do da'wah, we should spread the message of Islam as it is our duty to do so. السلام عليكم.